up, pessoal? This is Hey Mike here, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Yes, I'm back with another video of Brazil, and today I'm going to be reacting to Brazil's really cool banknotes. And if you guys haven't subscribed, just click the subscribe button to join the family and wait for more uploads and recommend new videos to watch. And yeah, with enough talking, let's just jump straight into the video.
During the pandemic, the demand for cash has plummeted. Here in the UK, for instance, many shops aren't even accepting cash, as contactless payments are, well, contactless and present less chance of transmission. But over in Brazil, the exact opposite has happened, with the increased demand for cash being so great that they've had to issue a new denomination of banknotes.
What? 200 real. New money?
This new note is now Brazil's highest in value and hasn't been without its controversies. So in this video, we're going to take a look at it, as well as the rest of the notes already in circulation. If you enjoy it, please consider subscribing. Brazil's currency is called the real, and the fronts of each banknote are largely the same. They each portray the effigy of the Republic, Brazil's national personification, similar to Britannia or Uncle Sam. At the top right and bottom left can be seen the note's denomination, presented on the 10, 20 and 200 in color-changing ink. On all notes, the denomination can be seen again in this box as a latent image, becoming visible if you tilt the note at just the right angle.
This is very,
and if you examine the notes with a magnifying glass, you'll see the denomination yet again in microprint across much of the design. Seriously, they've put the denomination everywhere, including...
I'm sure this takes like a lot of time. They put like a lot of time designing just this banknote, and I'm sure the printers must take a while to print this, because this is beautiful, man.
Putting under UV light, in the holographic strip of the 50 and 100, and hidden in this weird image here. It's what's known as a see-through register.
And I'm sure this is what, like, one of the hardest banknotes to like fake, because in my country you can easily fake a note because it just like has that one strip where you can identify to see if it's real or not. But this one looks like it's gonna take quite some time.
Half the design is printed on the front of the note, and the other half on the note's reverse, so when held up to light, the image completes.
Wow.
Counterfeiters often find it hard
That's
to perfectly
what I'm saying.
Align
it's
their
hard.
Printing. So if the images do match up, it's an indication that the note is genuine. Similarly, these seemingly abstract lines on the left and right edges of each note should perfectly join up if you bend the note like this, again indicating its authenticity. And finally, for the fronts, each note bears a different pattern of braille-like raised lines in the bottom right, to help the visually impaired distinguish between them, as well as being different in size to one another.
Not only is it beautiful, it accommodates everyone. If you're blind, it helps you if you can see. Like, it accommodates everyone. This is interesting. This is interesting. I've never seen this on any other note.
As with most banknotes, it's the reverse where the real really becomes unique and interesting. Each design depicts a different native animal. The two reals is a hawksbill turtle, with a starfish and two hatchlings on the right. The 5 portrays a great egret, whilst the 10 sees a green-winged macaw, one of the nation's most iconic birds.
Leo!
The 20 depicts a golden lion tamarin, and the 50 a magnificent jaguar. A dusky grouper can be seen on the 100, an enormous fish reaching up to 1.5 meters in length. And finally on the new 200 is a maned wolf. The animals of each note can be seen again in the watermark.
So the 200 is the new one, right?
Like the fronts, the reverses are covered in microprint, and under UV light simply see the serial number glow. So with all that out the way, let's talk about the 200 real and why exactly it caused such a stir. Firstly, the public largely objected to the animal portrayed, the maned wolf.
Like
they
hyena.
Argued it doesn't really represent the country, and a massive campaign was launched for the banknote to instead feature a caramel mongrel, Brazil's beloved street dog, becoming a widely shared sort of meme in the country. Now, I'd imagine that by this point, most of the 450 million new banknotes were likely already printed, so the government couldn't exactly change it. Instead, they featured a talking caramel mongrel in the advert promoting the new note. Although I don't speak Portuguese or dog, it seemed like a pretty great advert. But a more damning criticism is the value of the note, 200 reals. Aside from fears of inflation, large value notes are frequently used for criminal activity, and there's been a trend amongst countries in recent years to eliminate their excessively large notes, such as the 500 euro or 1000 rupee.
Damn.
Brazil suffers greatly with organized crime, and these new notes...
The one we used to use in Zimbabwe is like 80 million, just a note. It's not worth 80 million, but then... It's written 80 million or 30 billion or 10 billion. I don't know if you've heard of that, but then yeah, you can see from one of the examples here.
Notes only made things easier for the criminals. But even more damning, and perhaps even the note's death blow, is their physical size. Remember when I said the notes are sized differently to help the visually impaired differentiate between them?
It's the same as here in Malaysia, where I am right now. They also have the similar way, as the smaller the note is, the smaller the note is, the... What am I saying? That the lower the amount of the note is, the smaller the note is, yeah. And the bigger it is, the bigger it goes.
Well, the 200 breaks this pattern. In fact, it's the exact same size as the 20 real. After the note's release in August 2020, it only took until October for the first lawsuit to be filed, and they're showing no signs of going away. Brazil's central bank defended themselves, vaguely stating that due to the emergency nature of these notes, there was no time for adaption at the printers. There's also the issue of existing infrastructure, such as ATMs, that would need to be modified to accept a larger note. I can sort of sympathize with this. It was an unprecedented and urgent situation, and the new note does still have the tactile lines to differentiate. Certain countries, such as Canada, have banknotes that are all the same size and that just feature braille-like dots. But even still, it makes life a lot harder for the visually impaired. Either way, the future of these banknotes hangs in the balance, and Brazil's central bank are being fined for every day they do not remove them.
Damn.
So what do you think of the new note? Should it be removed, or should it only be valid whilst the pandemic is ongoing and the demand for cash higher? Aside from the controversies, these banknotes are colourful and secure, and do a fantastic job of highlighting the country's animals and biodiversity, if a little lacking in other cultural aspects.
My take on this is, like, okay, when you compare with the economy, I think they should drop them, the lawsuits should continue. But then, as they said, they want more money, and the need for money is way higher due to the pandemic, so they might as well keep it. But by now, I'm not sure, to be honest. I'm not an economist, but to the beauty aspect of it, like, it's a very beautiful note. We can't deny that. You can see it, like, it accommodates the blind. Not every note does that, but this one is beautiful, man. Like, yeah, man. But if you made it to the end of the video, please leave a comment, like, and subscribe, and see you on the next one. Peace.